Welcome back to this video series on improving our skills using Miro. Today we're going to talk about frames, and specifically about how frames can help you better contain your work, how they can help you export content from Miro into something more digestible like a PDF, and how you can use frames to create presentations right within Miro. So let's talk a little bit more about containing our content in Miro. So once you have a lot of things on your board, you'll fairly quickly find yourself wanting to group things in some kind of structured way that will allow you to more easily work with the information on your board. So before we really get into frames, I want to briefly talk about groups and why they're a little bit different than frames and when you would want to actually use a frame. So let's take this example where we have a couple of different colored sticky notes on the board. I'm going to shift and drag to select a couple of these sticky notes, and then I'm going to click this icon right here that's going to let me group or ungroup the content. So if I click that, now I have this group, and I'm able to click and drag any of the items in that group and drag them around. If I want to move something inside of a group around, the way that you do that is you select the group itself, and then you double click on the item that you want to move around, and that allows you to move something inside of a group. Now, if I wanted to add something to this group, like let's say I wanted to move this orange sticky into the group, you might expect to be able to move it over here and it would become part of the group. And that's not how it works. The group is the things that you have put specifically into the group. And the only way to get this other thing into it is to ungroup everything and then re-lasso and regroup. So now I have one chunk of things here. So grouping is nice when you just want to keep a few specific items together, but it's not very quick and flexible when you have lots of things that you want to kind of move in and out of a group. And that's the first use case where frames really can start benefiting your workflow. So I'm going to go ahead and ungroup these, and I want to create a frame with these sticky notes. So there's a couple of ways that I can do that. One way is I can lasso the group. I can click on the little meatball icon here for more. And one of the options here is going to be to create a frame. So you can notice when I do that, I automatically get a frame that's placed around this content. If you want to get rid of a frame, all you do is select the name of the frame and hit delete, and the frame goes away. It does not delete the content inside of the frame. So it's very easy to get rid of a frame if you don't need it. Another way that you can create a frame is to use the frame tool, which is over here. So you can either hit F to make this as part of your cursor, or you can click here to select the frame tool. Once you have that selected, you can just lasso these things or create whatever shape you want for the frame. And when you release your mouse, a frame will be created in the shape of whatever you dragged out. Once I have a frame, another thing I like to do with frames is to change the background color. So if I click here and I click on white, that allows me to give a little bit of a visual separation to this frame. So it's easier to see as kind of an entity on your Miro board, which is helpful when you start zooming out. You can really kind of see where your chunks of things are at in your board. So that's one of the first things you need to know about frames is just how to make them and kind of giving that contrast. Something else to learn about frames is right now, you can see that I have sticky notes that are just in kind of a random placement. There is this option to have either a grid or freeform organization. So if I move to the grid, it's going to automatically align these sticky notes together. And if I went ahead and let's say I duplicated a few of these, so if I had a few more sticky notes out here, if I drag them in, it's automatically going to place them very nicely in the frame. And if I want to go back to freeform, I can easily do that. And now I can place them wherever I want. And here's where we can kind of see that idea of comparing it to the group. If I click and drag the frame, you can see I can move the frame around just like a group. But if I move something out, now that's no longer a part of the frame and it stays on the outside of the board. If I want to move it back in, I can easily just drag it in and now it's part of the frame, and I can easily just click and move things around inside of the frame and we're good to go. There's nothing we have to do to add or move something from a frame. Just by having it contained in the frame, it automatically works like that. I can also just make the frame bigger and encapsulate this. And now that will be something that's part of the frame that can be moved around. So if I move, it stays in there. And if I move the frame border outside of that, now it will be outside of the frame and the frame will move around separately. So those are some frame basics. One other thing to notice that is kind of handy sometimes is this idea of a ratio. So right here, I have a custom ratio, which you notice when I move this around, I can kind of shape the frame in any pattern that I want, any dimensions. But if you click this ratio, you get some kind of standard ways of formatting the size of a frame. So I could do an A4, a letter, 16x9, if I was gonna do some maybe video work in here. And what happens with this is once you set that ratio, it's gonna remember that that ratio is set here. And you notice when I go to resize now, it doesn't matter if I'm on the border here or on the corner, I'm always gonna get the little diagonal dragger because when I drag it out, it's gonna keep it proportional to whatever this ratio is. You can change this on the fly if you wanna change it to a different ratio. You can very easily do that. And if you want to go back to having freeform control of the size of your frame, you just hit this custom one again. And then now you notice I get the little up down on the sides here to drag it out, or I can drag the corner to do some sizing here as well. So those are some basics for frames. If you want to create a frame with a default size, like let's say a page, you can just click the frame tool. And then if you just click the letter there, I'm going to get a new frame automatically that has this aspect ratio to it, and you're good to go. So that's kind of nice. Another feature in frames, this is only on paid accounts, but you can have a frame that's hidden. So if you want to develop some content in a frame and then you don't want to show it until later, till you know a certain time in your workshop when you want the participants to actually see what's there, you can click this little eyeball and that will hide the content that's inside of the frame. But that is only available on paid accounts. Something else I wanted to share with you is how you can use frames to more easily navigate content on maybe a larger, more complicated Miro board. So you'll see that we have this sticky note frame that we already created in the beginning, but I also have a couple more frames further down. So you can imagine maybe I have a big board that has lots more frames than this, but this should illustrate the concept of how this works. So there is this frame panel that is down in the bottom left of the Miro board. If I click on this, this will give me a listing of all the frames in this thumbnail size that I have on my board. And if I click on any one of these, it will instantly jump me to that location on the board. So this is a great way if you have very recognizable frames, but they're laid out in different ways that you can just come into this panel and click on one and jump to the right location. So this can be very handy. Another thing that can be useful for navigating boards is grabbing links to them to share. So let's say I wanted to share the sticky note board with somebody. I can click on the frame, I can right click or go to this little ... here. And one of the options is going to be to copy a link. So this will copy to my clipboard, a link to this board. And then I can paste that into a Slack message, let's say with a coworker to say, hey, come check out the board. And what happens is that will jump me to a specific location in the board. So you can see this by if I zoom way out and then I paste in that URL, when it loads and I come back into the board, it will automatically jump me to viewing that specific frame in the board. This can also be helpful to give some guidance to somebody when they come into a board. You may have not noticed this, but there is this notes feature on the top right of the Miro board. If I click this, it slides out and gives me the ability to type out possibly some instructions to someone. So I can say, when you open this board, check out this frame. So I can add in here a link, and then when I click this link, it will automatically move me to that specific frame. So this is a great way, again, to share a specific location in a board so somebody doesn't have to dig for it. This notes panel also has an even more advanced feature that's kind of similar to this, but if you click the little plus sign and then hit board object, this allows you to select something. So I could select, for instance, frame two and hit confirm. And then when I do that, not only is that gonna insert this thing that if I click the arrow, will also navigate me to that position on the board. It also gives me a nice thumbnail preview and a way to refresh that if some of the content there is changed. So that's a little bit more visual and dynamic way to add some navigation based off of frames into this notes feature. But the links also do the trick and are easy to share outside of Miro if you want to kind of have somebody jump into the board to collaborate with you. Another thing you can do with frames is once you have a frame built and you have some content in it, if you want to duplicate the entire frame, all you need to do is drag the name of the frame and hold down Alt, drag to a new location, and when you release, you will get a copy of that frame with all of the content inside it, so you can continue to modify it into a different version. So this is great for if you're doing a workshop where you get lots of stickies generated, but then you want to have multiple ways of visualizing or organizing that information. So you can get the content generated once and then do an exercise or maybe multiple exercises to organize it in different ways. So now that we've talked a little bit about some basics for frames, I want to talk about a few other things. So one other thing I've done in this board is I have created several frames. And this is the part where we're going to talk a little bit about the next category, which is exporting content by using frames. So once you have frames in Miro, this is kind of the mechanism Miro uses to be able to export content out of Miro. So once I have a frame, I can click on a frame. And then if I get to the little meatball more icon there and I hit export as image, it will give me some options here. So I can do a small, medium, large, or vector to be able to export a frame. And if I do vector, you'll notice I can have the option for a PDF. So once I do that, this is gonna generate a PDF for me and I can have that show up. You see, I get a PDF that has that frame exported as a PDF. So this is a good way to get a single frame out of Miro. Now, another thing you could do is you can export this entire board as a PDF. And what this is gonna do is not just export the whole board, it's gonna export a PDF that has the frames you have inside of that board as pages in the PDF. So you notice if I say export, and now I'm gonna get this PDF that has multiple pages to it. So you see I have five pages. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I have my original one that we were just messing around with the sticky notes as number 5. Okay, so let's say you export these and you don't like the order that they're in. You want slide 3 to be before slide 2 or something like that. So the thing you need to know is that the frames are exported in a certain order, and that is determined by the frames panel. You can get to the frames panel by clicking this icon down in the bottom left, and that will slide out this panel. So you can see here, now we have all the frames that we can see. It has a thumbnail preview list, and it also has a smaller list form. If you have a lot that you just want to kind of collapse it down, you can do that. So the order that the frames are in this list on the side is the order that they will appear in your PDF file. So if I wanted to change the order, I add 1, 1, 4, 3, 2, and then let's say I wanted this one up at the top, I can drag those around. And now if I go to my share export, hit save as PDF, go ahead and do another export here. You'll see now that in my resulting PDF that I get, we will have the pages in the order that I have specified in that frames panel. So my frame 1, 4, 3, 2. So this is the order that I've put it into. All right, so that's how you export content in Miro. It's by using frames and then ordering them in the way that you want, or exporting an individual frame by clicking on its header here. So here's another tip. Sometimes you're working on a large Miro board and you want to keep a history point of a frame to see what it looked like at a previous point in time, but you want to continue working on the frame to move the content forward. So one of the things I've done is instead of just duplicating the frame outright, I will export the frame. So let's do that. I'm gonna export a PDF. And then once I have that export, I will drag the exported file back into Miro. And now I have a snapshot from the PDF of what that looked like. Now I can't change this. There's nothing that I can do to modify the content, but if all you need is a visual reference of what the frame looked at a point in time, this will be more performant than having an additional copy that's editable of all the frame's content. The next thing I wanted to briefly discuss is doing presentations in Miro. So this works very similar to how the frames export works. So I have my frame panel over here that I show the different frames that I have. But now if I go down and click on this presentation mode in the bottom left, this will put me into a mode where I can walk through the different slides. So if I go back to the beginning here at slide one, if I click next, it will slide me to that place on the board for that frame. This will also change in scale. So if I had, let me get out of this here. So if I exit the presentation mode, scroll out, and let's say that frame four was very big. And if I go back to presentation mode, you'll see that it's going to scale and zoom as well as transition me to whatever slide I have. And again, this order follows the order of the frames over here on the left. So this is the way to do presentations in Miro. If you wanted to have a frame that has slide-like content, this is a great way to walk through that using Miro as your presentation tool. All right, so I hope you've learned a lot from today's video on when and how you can use frames to improve your experience working in Miro. If you got value out of today's video, it'd really help me if you'd hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more tips on using Miro and other productivity tips and things related to product management and software, gear, and all kinds of other stuff. So look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks for watching.